going on, y'all? It's the Caveman back at it again with another video, and the offseason is here. The Bills offseason has finally come. I mean, it's been here for a while now. It's been a couple weeks, even though I feel like we haven't seen a Bills game in freaking ages. I feel like we haven't watched the Bills in forever, and it sucks. I hate the offseason. I just want to watch Bills football once again. But I digress. We are just as good as the rest of the NFL at this point. We're not playing in the Super Bowl game, but it is what it is. We have a long offseason ahead of us. A lot of big things are to come, and I'm excited to see what direction we head in as a franchise. It's only been a short time since that AFC Championship game in which we lost to the Chiefs, but there has been a lot of rumors already bouncing around. A lot of people in the fan base, a lot of people that are fans of the Bills have their own idea of where they think the Buffalo Bills should head in the future, and a lot of different, you know, ideas and directions that they think that the Bills should head in the future. And I want to give my two cents on all these rumors. There have been a lot of big names that have already come out to potentially be Buffalo Bills in the future. And I'm literally looking forward to what the offseason has in store for us. And I'm going to give you my opinions on all the rumors that have come out as of late. Just so weird this offseason that we're a good team with personality now. Like, we were a good team last year. Stephon Diggs not only elevated our team to being even better, he also brought personality. We are going to be a team that a lot of big name free agents want to come to. We haven't been that team. We haven't been a top destination for free agents in a long time, I feel like. Not for a long time that I've been alive, at least. Like, when's the last time anybody as a free agent has said, hey, maybe I want to go to Buffalo? It has not happened in a long freaking time. So let's not waste any more time. Let's just address some of these rumors that have come out. And on the defensive side of the ball, two big names have emerged as potential players that can be coming to the Bills in the future. And the first one was JJ Watt. That rumor kind of came to fruition a couple weeks ago. And right at first, as soon as I heard it, I was like, yeah, I'm going to stay away from that one. That's a big old hell no from me. It sounds great, you know, on pen and paper. It sounds fantastic. But when you really take a deep dive into JJ Watt, especially after the season he's had, it's a big hell nah, man. You just cannot take this amount of money, put it into a guy that you're probably not going to get any sort of return in. When the rumor first came out, a lot of people were saying, yeah, I'd love to see JJ Watt in a Bills uniform. I'd love to get JJ Watt on this team. JJ Watt would fit Buffalo, blah, blah, blah. And as much as some of that's true, you just can't pay that much money for a guy like JJ Watt, especially after the season he just had. In comparison to Jerry Hughes, he only had half a sack more, and he actually had less QB pressures on more pass rush snaps in comparison to Jerry Hughes. So his production was just nowhere near what it should be, especially for the amount of money he's going to be receiving. And I can hear out the argument that JJ Watt is a locker room guy. He's a veteran presence. He really elevates your team off the field. And I can hear that argument. Don't get me wrong. That is JJ Watt's A game. That is where JJ Watt is best. But I also feel like in order to really elevate a team in that sort of sense, you also need to have on-field production to back up that passion off the field. Stephon Diggs brings both of those, and JJ Watt unfortunately brings one, which is off the field, and the production on the field just isn't there. And I feel like in order to really elevate a team in that sort of aspect, you need to have both factors, and JJ Watt just doesn't bring both, unfortunately. And for the amount of money he's going to be asking for, it's just virtually just impossible to even think that this is a good idea. It's just a big old hell nah. JJ Watt, I'm sorry. I really love the guy. He's a fantastic dude, but he just does not fit the Buffalo Bills. The other huge name that came out on the defensive side of the ball that could potentially be coming a Buffalo Bill in the offseason is Richard Sherman. PFF was the first one to come out with this, and they said that they project the Bills to sign Richard Sherman in the offseason. And I'm a little more lenient on this one compared to JJ Watt. I didn't hear this at first and think, hell no, like I did with JJ Watt. I'm a little more on the fence, but the more I really read into it, it was just a little more of a no the more and more I thought about it. Richard Sherman is another guy. He's a big name that is going to be asking for a lot of money. But let's look at the statistics and look at the bigger picture here. Richard Sherman came off of one of his better years in 2019 and then rolled that into 2020 and really had actually his worst season in his entire career. He actually had a 67.2 coverage grade graded by PFF, which was the worst in his entire career. I don't think you want to be putting a lot of money into a guy that's coming off of the worst year in his entire career. You don't know how it's going to pan out coming to a new team, a new environment. You don't know if he's going to bounce back. And to me, that's more of a gamble. And we're not getting the return, in my opinion, that I think would be worth paying him all that money. That's just too much of a gamble. When you're putting in that much money into a guy, you want there to be for sure return. You don't want there to be a gamble, and that's what comes with Richard Sherman. We need a second cornerback, don't get me wrong, but I just feel like our secondary is the last place we need to be dumping our cap space into. Like, we can address the secondary in other ways, and spending all that money on the secondary when that's probably the last thing we need to be dumping our money into, it just doesn't seem smart to me. I feel like there's other ways we can fix the secondary that doesn't include spending all of our money on one guy. It just seems stupid, in my opinion, to be doing that in the area of our team that we really realistically don't need to do that in. There are just so many other places that that money can go towards that isn't a secondary, especially Richard Sherman. I just think that it would just be a very risky investment for an upgrade that you're not even sure you're getting, a very who knows what you're going to get from Richard Sherman this season. I mean, he came off of his worst season in his career. You don't know what you're going to get, and you're paying him a lot of money. So that's just too much of a risk for me. And let's be real here. Who the hell likes Richard Sherman? Like, that dude's annoying. Like, that dude's got a loud mouth. That dude is saying some shit every other week. Who the hell? Like, this guy's annoying. Like, I've never personally liked Richard Sherman. I don't want to have to root for Richard Sherman because he's wearing our colors. Let's be real here. I don't like Richard Sherman. I just, you know, just stay away, Richard Sherman, all right? I would not really like that. Now, there are a ton of other decisions we're going to have to make, like whether or not we re-sign Milano, what we're going to do with Edmonds. We have a lot of decisions to be making on the defensive side of the ball when it comes to the guys we already have on our roster. I don't know what's going to happen, and I'm not going to sit here and try to predict it because it's just too much of a mind fuck. I really don't know what's going to happen. Are we going to re-sign Milano? Are we not going to re-sign Milano? I personally think we should. People are speculating that he's actually not as good as he is. I disagree. I think Matt Milano is a very good linebacker. I think he should be in a Bills uniform next season. I would hate to see him walk, but I'm not going to really get into all of that. I'm just going to address more of the hotter rumors and more of the hotter conversation. Even though Matt Milano is up there in hot conversation, I'm just going to stay away from that aspect of things for now. Shifting our focus to the offensive side of the ball, there really hasn't been, you know, big names that have come out to be potential Bills players in the future, but compared to, you know, the defensive side of the ball with J.J. Watt and Richard Sherman, there really isn't that J.J. Watt or Richard Sherman for the offense yet. We don't know who could be coming here, but I personally don't think it needs to be a freaking running back. Let's address the running back situation right now, all right? The first thing I'm going to say, loud and clear, do not draft a running back with our pick. No, don't do it. Stay away. Najee Harris, Travis Etienne, however the hell you say his last name, I do not want them. They are fantastic individual players, but they are not going to fix the run game. We have drafted two running backs over the past 2 years, and all of a sudden, they're the reasons that our run game isn't working, or maybe it's because the offensive line just gets completely washed and penetrated when we try to run the ball inside. We have no running game because the interior offensive line, it's not very good when it comes to the run game. Like, you can't not sit here and tell me that it's our two running backs. We drafted two different running backs the past 2 years. You're going to tell me they're the problem here, not the interior offensive line. Those two guys are very capable running backs, and they've shown flashes of being very good. We need to restructure the interior offensive line. The run game is not going to improve by drafting one of these high prospect running backs. It's not. I feel like it's a waste of a pick. Why draft a third running back in the third year just to have him probably not pan out the way you thought the last two guys would? It's just a waste of a pick. We do not need to improve the running back room. We need to reconstruct the interior offensive line in order to run the ball better. And don't get me wrong, I want us to run the ball, but I don't want us to run the ball more. We need to run the ball better. We need to run the ball with more quality. We do not need more quantity when running the ball. We want the ball in Josh Allen's hands more often than not. We do not need Devin Singletary and Zach Moss getting more carries than they already were. We just need their carries to be more productive. I also saw some rumors, very small, very, very few rumors about Aaron Jones potentially being, like, I saw some people talking about Aaron Jones, you know, coming to the Bills. You know, that's another big old hell nah, all right? We do not need to spend that much money on a position that doesn't help us. Signing Aaron Jones does not help us that much, I'm sorry. And that's just too much money to be putting in a spot that I personally feel like we do not need to put that much money into. Spot on the offensive side of the ball, I feel like we need to address is the tight end position. Holy shit, we were a mess with tight ends this season. We couldn't figure shit out when it came to the tight ends. Like, Tyler Croft disappeared into oblivion. Who the hell knows what happened to that guy after the Rams game, but we didn't hear a peep from him. I don't know why. I don't know what we were doing with our tight ends, but it just was not working. I am off the Dawson Knox train. I'm sorry. I love the kid. I'm off the train, though. We need more production, and we need it. We're going to need it now. We're in a win-now situation. We can't really be waiting for such a prominent position, such an important position to be developing within the next couple of years. He's had enough time, enough on-field experience where we should be seeing more from him, and we need more impact from that position. Watching that Chiefs game, the difference between us and the Chiefs, they have very good receivers. Don't get me wrong. They have Hill and Kelce. Obviously, those are the two big names. But Travis Kelce is a big-bodied receiver that is able to fight against physical coverage. We don't really have that. We had a bunch of, well, for one, they were all injured, but we were getting pressed. We were getting covered very hard Chiefs on defense when we played against them in the AFC Championship game. Granted, our guys were not completely healthy, but if we have a tight end there that's able to get separation, an elite tight end that's able to fight off against physical coverage, that's able to be more of a safety blanket for Josh Allen, that makes a big difference in that game. I don't think we win that game still, but nevertheless, we need a tight end that's a bigger body that can fight off physical coverage, and we really didn't have that, and that's a big downfall. I think that's a very big important piece to to having an offense that's going to be successful. Cameron Brayton, Rob Gronkowski are humongous pieces of the Bucs offense. Travis Kelce, there's nothing to be said about Travis Kelce. That dude's just a humongous piece of that offense. Zach Ertz was a humongous piece of the offense for the Eagles when they won. I mean, I can go on and on about elite tight ends that have been on Super Bowl winning rosters. We need one if we're going to be a Super Bowl winning team. We need an elite tight end, and we're going to have to go and find one. There were rumors about trading for Zach Ertz way earlier in the season, and I would have loved for that to happen. Maybe it'll happen in this offseason. Maybe we'll go out and get a guy in free agency. I know Hunter Henry, Gerald Everett, and Jonnu Smith are the three guys that I have my eye on personally. Those are three tight ends that I feel like can make a difference on this roster, and I really like their game. They have shown flashes of very good production where they already are. So those three guys I have my eye on. I would really like us to, you know, maybe tap into the free agent market when it comes to tight ends, but we really needed an upgrade there if we want to really improve our offense, in my opinion. I think if we're going to put money into the offensive side of the ball, it shouldn't be a running back. It should be a tight end. We need a game-changing tight end. I actually have two things to say. The first one is I would genuinely be fine if we kept this entire roster from this season, carried it over into next season, but we just had one change, and that was a pass rusher. If we just went out and got one pass rusher, kept everything else the same, I would be happy with that. Our team was Super Bowl ready beside for our pass rush. The difference between us, the Chiefs, and the Buccaneers was our pass rush. The Chiefs were down Josh Allen's throat all game. Chris Jones was in his face all game. Josh Allen did not have a second because of the pass rush the Chiefs brought to him. The Buccaneers did not give Aaron Rodgers a second to breathe because of the pass rush they have and they were bringing to Aaron Rodgers. That is the difference between us and those Super Bowl teams. We need a pass rush, and we need to go out there and get a pass rusher. Forget the rest of it. Forget the running back. Forget the tight end. Forget the secondary. Forget all the rest of it. Forget it. We need pass rush. That's the bottom line. Pass rush wins championships. That is how we are going to be a Super Bowl team, is when we get pass rush, when we get consistent pressure on the quarterback, especially with just four guys. We need more pressure if we want to be a Super Bowl winning team. Having a pass rusher, whether it be a linebacker or a DN or a D-tackle, anybody in the front seven, an elite pass rusher is what wins championships behind a quarterback, obviously. We need that. We need it desperately. We need it so horribly, and that's what we really lack in comparison to the Chiefs and the Bucs. We need an elite pass rusher that can get to the quarterback consistently and really disrupt play after play for the opposing offense. And the second thing I want to just say real quick is that whatever McBean decides to do, whoever they go out and decide to sign in free agency, whoever we decide to draft, you know, I'm going to trust whatever they decide to do. No matter if I agree with them or not, I'm going to believe in the process and trust the process they are putting into place here in Buffalo. They brought us to the AFC Championship game. We're here because of them. They drafted Josh Allen. They know what the hell they're doing. They could go out and sign both J.J. Watt and Richard Sherman by some miraculous miracle if we could find the money. They could go and do that. As much as I would disagree with it, I would trust it because I know they know what they're doing. Because at the end of the day, my freaking opinion, it don't freaking matter to what the Bills office is, the Bills general management does. They don't care what I have to say, okay? Obviously, I know that. So at the end of the day, I'm going to trust what they do because they're the smart ones. They're the geniuses. They're the ones that are going to take our team to the next level, and I trust every move they're going to make in this offseason. There's so much more I could have addressed. I mean, there's so many different things that could potentially happen in this offseason, and it's just too much to address in one video. I wanted to highlight the bigger things that I felt like were important, and that's what I did in this video. I want to know what you think of my opinions. I want to know what you think the Bills need to do in the future. Any thoughts you have, I want you to leave them down below. You guys know that I love to interact with you guys in the comments. That's my favorite part of doing this whole YouTube thing. Talking to you guys is the best part. So I want to know your thoughts down below. If you enjoyed the video, like, subscribe, do all that fun stuff. If you want to hit that bell to be notified when I upload, I would appreciate that. I would also appreciate if you want to go follow me on Twitter. I did that last video I did with the polls. If you don't want to miss out on shit like that, go follow me over there on Twitter. And I'll see y'all later in the next one. Peace.